Welcome to week three of Digital Design 2 Online, and get rolling here with some more JavaScript. So this week, the goals are for you to complete Code Academy Unit 4 and 5 for scopes and arrays for functions, and then create a magic 8-ball. You're also going to be creating a color-changing site and an assignment of random number generator. So I'm going to kind of pose a challenge to you for the color changing website later this week. I will post a tutorial about it as well as the answer. But what I want you to do is attempt to create it on your own in addition to the Magic 8-Ball and random number generator. So just some overview real quick. The color changing site is all about how to get the background to change on a website. So it's a really simple site. It looks like this. Essentially, I click this button and the background changes to a random color. This is working with random numbers and getting them to work with the CSS and take over the CSS by just clicking this button. And the reason I want to do this is so you can create those random number generators and practice with that a little bit more. So just to review real quick, in CSS, it's important to know that you can control the color of a background, not just by listing the name, but by also doing an RGB color. And remember, RGB is red, green, blue. And to do that in CSS, you type RGB, and then in parentheses, you put the red value first in a number format, comma, green value in number format, comma, blue value in number format. So you can see here we've got some RGBs for these different colors depending on how much blue, green, and red are in those colors. And remember, they go from zero of no intensity, not visible, to 255 being 100% as bright as it possibly can be. So you can see here, like this one is 255 for red and zero for green and blue, meaning it's just going to show red. So essentially what you're going to do in a color changing site is your goal is to make these three values random. Random between the numbers of 0 and 255. So the question is, how can you create something that will override the CSS and make those a random number? And that's that color changing site. The other assignment that I wanted to show you is a magic 8-ball. And so you can get pretty creative with this, but the goal is to kind of integrate your CSS and your HTML together along with JavaScript. And so I'm going to show you two examples. This one's a pretty simple one where you're just typing in a yes or no question, will I win? And there's an answer and it generates. You want to have an affirmative, a negative, and a neutral, at least three, but you can have a ton. And you can see I can keep clicking answer and it will tell me whether or not I'm going to get that. Here's another example that was almost completely finished, but very CSS and HTML related. And here again, will I win? And you can click to see your result and it shows down here. And you can see I'm getting different ones when I am clicking it. So you wanna have those random answers pop up because that's how a Magic 8-Ball works. It's random. So all together, we're gonna go ahead and just work on continuing in JavaScript and then finishing up those assignments. And then the random number generator is just where you tell the website, like, I want to generate a number between 0 and 500, and it generates a number. So you can put in parameters of whether or not, like, what's the lowest number and the highest number it can go to, and then generates a random number in there. So lots of working with random numbers. Your Magic 8-Ball can even work with arrays to come up with different answers and those kinds of things. So just integrating those into your websites using CodePen, because CodePen allows you to code in all three together. So if you have any questions, don't hesitate to contact me, and I hope you have a fantastic week.